Good evening. This is Pastor Bruce Grant from Our Savior's Lutheran Church in Roy, Utah, welcoming you to our service of shadows, the Tenebrae service here on Good Friday. It's a beautiful night here in northern Utah, and we welcome you and pray and trust as you experience this service with us. You will be drawn closer to what Jesus Christ did for you on the cross and for me and for all of us. He died to pay for our sins to give us eternal life received by faith in Him alone. So we hope you enjoy the service. It will get darker as the service moves on. We have 7 candles that will be extinguished one by one as I read through the scriptures and we sing as well. So we hope you enjoy the service and we pray and trust that you'll be drawn closer to Jesus Christ as a result. Surely goodness
to bear Specifically for Good Friday. O Christ, Lamb of God, slain for the sin of the world, with a penitent heart we come to your cross, pleading for mercy and forgiveness. For us you tasted the agony and the utter darkness that we may not perish, but have everlasting life. O Christ, Lamb of God, embrace us with your love and forgive us all our sins. Your death brings healing to our souls and cleansing to our hearts. We behold you bleeding, despised, forsaken, dying, and pierced. O Christ, Lamb of God, our hearts find hope in your words, comfort in your promises, and salvation in your finished work on the cross, by which you have overcome sin, Satan, and death. Our hands are unclean, our lips are sullied. In love you came to us, but you were rejected by hate. Yet you forgave them as you forgive us. We confess the great mystery that confronts us at the tomb of sin and death. But you, O Christ, carried with you to the grave our sin and death, that their hold on us is now broken.
O Lord, have mercy. O Christ, have mercy. Lord, hear our
Heavenly Father, we are silenced at the grave of your Son, who knew no sin, yet was made sin for us. You permitted him to die, exchanging his innocence for our guilt. Christ taught us obedience, but men rebelled against him. We confess our faith, and it is by faith that we know he suffered and died.
Trinity, one God who forgives all our sin, whose mercy endures forever.
Amen.
If we say we have no sin, we deceive ourselves, and the truth is not in us. But if we confess our sins, God who is faithful
will sins and cleanse us from all unrighteousness. Let us take a brief moment and ask the Holy Spirit where we fall short of God's standard of holiness, confess those sins, and receive the forgiveness that we have in the shed blood of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Let us confess aloud together. Most merciful God, we confess that we are a captive to sin and cannot free ourselves. We have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have
done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us. Forgive us, renew us, and lead us, so that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways, to the glory of your holy name.
Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, you're forgiven, brothers and sisters of Christ. Not because
on our part, but because of the death and resurrection of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. For he who knew no sin suffered and died, so that we would live. Let us now say the Lord's Prayer together. Our Father,
who art in heaven,
for
together, firm in our faith. We believe in one God,
the Father, Almighty, Maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the Giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Christian and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
May be seated.
After Jesus had spoken these words, he went out with his disciples across the Kidron Valley to a place where there was a garden, which he and his disciples entered. Now Judas, who betrayed him, also knew the place, because Jesus often met there with his disciples. So Judas brought a detachment of soldiers together with police from the chief priests and the Pharisees, and they came there with lanterns and torches and weapons. Then Jesus, knowing all that was to happen to him, came forward and asked them, "Whom are you looking for?" They answered, "Jesus of Nazareth." Jesus replied, "I am he." Judas, who betrayed him, was standing with them. When Jesus said to them, "I am he," they stepped back and fell to the ground. Again he asked them, "Whom are you looking for?" And they said, "Jesus of Nazareth." Jesus answered, I told you that I am he. So if you're looking for me, let these men go. This was to fulfill the word that he had spoken. I did not lose a single one of those whom you gave me. Then Simon Peter, who had a sword, drew it, struck the high priest's slave, and cut off his right ear. The slave's name was Malchus. Jesus said to Peter, "Put your sword back into its sheath. Am I not to drink the cup that the Father has given me?" The Gospel of the Lord. Thank you. You may be seated.
So the soldiers, their officer, and the Jewish police arrested Jesus.
And first they took him to Annas, who was the father-in-law of Caiaphas, the high priest that year. Caiaphas was the one who had advised the Jews that it was better to have one person die for the people. Simon Peter and another disciple followed Jesus. Since that disciple was known to the high priest, he went with Jesus into the courtyard of the high priest, but Peter was standing outside at the gate. So the other disciple who was known to the high priest went out, spoke to the woman who guarded the gate, and brought Peter in. The woman said to Peter, "You are not also one of this man's disciples, are you?" He said, "I am not." Now the slaves and the police had made a charcoal fire because it was cold, and they were standing around it and warming themselves. Peter also was standing with them and warming himself.
We
high priest questioned Jesus about his disciples and about his teaching. Jesus answered, I have spoken openly to the world. I have always
been in the temple where all the Jews come together. I have said nothing in secret. Why do you ask me? Ask those who heard what I said to them. They know what I said. When he had said this, one of the police standing nearby struck Jesus on the face, saying, Is that how you answer the high priest? Jesus answered, If I have spoken wrongly, testify to the wrong. But if I have spoken rightly, why do you strike me? Then Annas sent him bound to Caiaphas, the high priest. Now Simon Peter was standing and warming himself. They asked him, You are not also one of his disciples, are you? He denied it and said, I am not. One of the slaves of the high priest, a relative of the man whose ear Peter had cut off, asked, Did I not see you in the garden with him? Again, Peter denied it, and at that moment, the cock crowed.
They took Jesus from Caiaphas to Pilate's headquarters. It was early in the morning. They themselves did not enter the headquarters so as to avoid ritual defilement and to be able to eat.
So Pilate went out to them and said, What accusation do you bring against this man? They answered, If this man were not a criminal, we would not have handed him over to you. Pilate said to them, Take him yourselves and judge him according to your law. The Jews replied, We are not permitted to put anyone to death. This was to fulfill what Jesus had said when he indicated the kind of death he was to die. Then Pilate entered the headquarters again, summoned Jesus and asked him, Are you the king of the Jews? Jesus answered, Do you ask this on your own, or did others tell you about me?" Pilate replied, "I am not a Jew, am I? Your own nation and the chief priests have handed you over to me. What have you done?" Jesus answered, "My kingdom is not from this world. If my kingdom were from this world, my followers would be fighting to keep me from being handed over to the Jews. But as it is, my kingdom is not from here." Pilate asked him, "So you are a king?" Jesus answered, "You say that I am a king. For this I was born, and for this I came into the world, to testify to the truth. Everyone who belongs to the truth listens to my voice." Pilate asked him, "What is truth?" After he had said this, he went out to the Jews again and told them, "I find no case against him, but you have a custom that I release someone for you at the Passover. Do you want me to release for you the King of the Jews?" They shouted in reply, "Not this man, but Barabbas!" Barabbas was a robber and a murderer. Then Pilate took Jesus and had him flogged. And the soldiers wove a crown of thorns and put it on his head, and they dressed him in a purple robe. They kept coming up to him, saying, "Hail, King of the Jews," and striking him on the face. The stone pavement, or in Hebrew, Gabbatha. Now it was the day of preparation for the Passover, and it was about noon. He said to the Jews, "Here is your king." They cried out, "Away with him! Away with him! Crucify him!" Pilate asked them, "Shall I crucify your king?" The chief priest answered, "We have no king but the emperor." Then he handed him over to them to be crucified. Of the skull, which in Hebrew is called Golgotha. There they crucified him, and with him two others, one on either side, with Jesus between them. Pilate also had an inscription written and put on the cross. It read, "Jesus of Nazareth, the King of the Jews." Many of the Jews read this inscription because the place where Jesus was crucified was near the city, and it was written in Hebrew, in Latin, and in Greek. Then the chief priests of the Jews said to Pilate, "Do not write the King of the Jews, but this man said, 'I am King of the Jews.'" Pilate answered, "What I have written, I have written." When the soldiers had crucified Jesus, they took his clothes and divided them into four parts, one for each soldier. They also took his tunic. Now the tunic was seamless, woven in one piece from the top. So they said to one another, "Let us not tear it, but cast lots for it to see who will get it." This was to fulfill what the scripture says, "They divided my clothes among themselves, and for my clothing they cast lots." And that is what the soldiers did.
The coming of the cross, pain. Could you take away the pain? If I had someone to blame, would it make my life seem easier? Alone, all my friends are asleep, and I can't find anyone to stay awake with me. Where were you when sin stole my innocence? Where were you when I was ashamed? Hiding in a life I wish I'd never made. My God, all alone, all alone. You were on the cross. You died for us all alone, all alone. You were the cross. Victorious. All alone. All alone. You were there in all of my suffering. You were there in doubt and in fear, waiting on the dawn on to reappear.
Meanwhile, standing near the cross of Jesus were his mother and his mother's sister Mary, the wife of Joseph,
and Mary Magdalene. When Jesus saw his mother and the disciple whom he loved standing beside her, he said to his mother, "Woman, here is your son." Then he said to the disciple, "Here is your mother." And from that hour, the disciple took her into his own home. From noon on, darkness came over the whole land until 3 p.m. And about 3:00, Jesus cried with a loud voice, "Eloi," that is, my God, why have you forsaken me?"
After this, when Jesus knew that all was now finished, he said, in order to fulfill the scripture, I am thirsty. A jar full of sour wine was standing there. So they put a sponge full of the wine on a branch of hyssop and held it to his mouth. When Jesus had received the wine, he said, it is finished. And he bowed his head.
At that moment, the curtain of the temple was torn in two, from top to bottom. The earth shook and the rocks were split. The tombs also were opened, and many bodies of the saints who had fallen asleep were raised. Now when the centurion and those with him who were keeping watch over Jesus saw the earthquake and what took place, they were terrified and said, truly, this man was God's son.